through station. This might not be as useful as the situation where both trains wait for each other, but I am sure there are some interesting implications in this. While I was making this video, I discovered more differences between RCT2 Vanilla and Open RCT2. I don't want to remake the entire video, so I will put it in here. In Vanilla or Classic, you enable the synchronize option, but there is no station for you to synchronize with, it will simply stop going. This means that the previous setups where only one or two stations synchronizes don't work. The blue station will wait for the red station at normal, but since there is no station for the red one to synchronize with, it will never leave the station, leading to the blue train also never leaving the station. Situations like this have happened before and will probably happen again. I do all of my testing in Open RCT2 and I don't know all the intended or unintended changes that have been made. I try to also test things in Vanilla or Classic when I think that's necessary, but it takes a lot longer and sometimes I just forget about it. Now that you know how the synchronization option works, let's see how this applies to setups that have more than two coasters. The first one is simple, and that is multiple stations that all synchronize with each other. If you have four stations like these two setups, they will all wait for each other and only depart if all four have a train ready. As long as all the stations are in the synchronization range of all other stations, this works. The most stations you can synchronize at once is 16. If you have more than that and they all have the option checked, one of them will not depart the station at all. Which one it is seems to be based on position of the map. No matter in which order I build these 18 stations or in which order I enable the synchronization options, the new stations are missing. Synchronization range of all other stations, this works. The most